Hello everyone and welcome back to Kobian History. In today's medieval professions video, we'll go over the slate industry, both during the medieval times and also when it picked up in the slate booms which happened during the 19th century. This video is dedicated to my patron Parker Dye as part of his $25 pledge on Patreon. He himself is from Wales, so as you might know, Wales played a big part in the slate industry in the British Isles. We'll start by covering what slate was used for. Slate was used for many things, but most commonly it can be made into roofing slates, which are used by a slater to build a roof. Slate is a relatively easy material for roofers to work with, as it's possible to split the stone into thin sheets. And when broken, the slate also retains its natural appearance, while remaining relatively flat and thus also easy to stack. Thicker slabs of slates have its uses as well, as it can be used for flooring, worktops, headstones, and more. The term slate is also widely used to refer to different objects made from the slate material. For example, a roofing tile made of slate may be simply called a slate. In the 1800s, pieces of slates were set into a wooden frame, which was widely used by school students to write on. These are referred to as writing slates. They were easily wiped clean with a cloth, and that's where the terms clean slate or blank slate originate from. Slate is particularly suitable as a roofing material, as it has an extremely low water absorption index, making the material waterproof. It also has the lowest embodied energy of all roofing materials, meaning that it has a high energy efficiency. Natural slate also looks good and is durable. In some cases, slate roofs can even last several hundred years with little to no maintenance. Because it doesn't easily absorb water, it is also very resistant to frost damage, while on the other end of the spectrum, it is also very fire resistant. Now we'll cover a bit of the history of slate, starting with the Romans. The slate industry in Britain can be traced back to the Romans, as the first proper roofing slate shingles were found in Roman settlements. We'll take the Roman fort of Saguntum as an example, which was located in what is now Carnarvon. While this fort was originally roofed with clay tiles, in later ages slate was implemented and used both for the roofing and the flooring of the fort. The nearest slate deposits were about 5 miles or 8 kilometers away, which indicates that the Romans found slate useful enough to transport it over distance rather than using local resources as a substitute. Typical Roman roofing slates had a rough diamond shape with a single nail hole at its head. But once the Romans left the Isles in the 5th century, the roofing slate traditions left with them, and it would be half a millennia before we find records of roofing slates again. The Saxons did not use slate very much, and they preferred thatch roofs instead. In these times, stone in general was reserved for churches. However, this changed in the 11th century with the arrival of the Normans. Historical records mention there was a roofing slate quarry somewhere in South Devon, which is the first mention of the industry in the Middle Ages. In southern England, records from the 12th century show that thousands of slates were already coming to the areas around Southampton, Winchester, and Portchester from ports in Devon. And this trade continued through the Middle Ages, with the regions of Dorset and Cornwall also starting to supply slate later on. During the Welsh Wars of Independence, Edward I of England is reputed to have slept under a slate roof in the Nantlie Valley. This seems to have been notable enough to be written down, which may suggest that roofs made of slate were prized even by the higher ranks of society. The use of blue slate in England grew during the 13th century, as there was a general movement towards more robust and less flammable roofing materials. Blue slate is a type of slate which we mentioned earlier, coming from the southwestern parts of England. which was growing to become the main supplying region of slates for England, as we start finding the use of blue slate spreading further east and north, mostly to places that had access to transport by sea or river. Though still a rare find in these areas, blue slate has been found to be used in high status buildings as far away as Canterbury, London, Colchester, Bury St. Edmunds, Norwich, and even as far north as Lincoln, among other places. Around the same time, Conwy and Carnarvon castles, both in Wales, were also re-roofed, but as they were in Wales, of course here they used Welsh slates to do this. Unless there was a local deposit, only the most prestigious buildings had slate roofs, as transporting these slabs was expensive. Land transportation was very difficult, so transport by boat was the chosen method wherever it was possible. As most of the English slate market was already being supplied by the blue slate from the regions around Devon, as well as northern England having slate deposits in Cumbria, the medieval Welsh slate industry instead exported most of their slate to Ireland. But keep in mind that this early Welsh slate industry was still very small compared to what it was going to become in future centuries. Slate was split and cut into roofing tiles at the quarry, and then shipped by sea or river to the building site. There, further modifications were made to fix the slates onto the roof. The following example of medieval roof fixing comes from a find in Colchester. Most of the slates seem to have been either broad and rectangular or narrow rectangular in shape. These slates included a fixing hole which would have been used to attach them to the wood beams on the roof. These fixing holes were quite small, which suggests the use of copper nails rather than the standard wooden peg fixings which were used in many aspects of construction in the Middle Ages. In some of the slates, notches were also carved, which may have been done to fit around the nails of surrounding slates. Slaters also had special tools, such as a slater's hammer, which had a claw on one end for drawing nails, as well as having a shear edge for cutting slate and a head with a sharp point for punching holes in the slate. They also had other tools for trimming slates or to precisely split the slate so it would fit perfectly on the roof. The slate industry grew slowly until the Industrial Revolution, when large-scale slate mining began. This, combined with the advent of the railway soon after, caused this industry to grow rapidly, as rail transport was a fast and cheap alternative to sea and river transport. Whereas during earlier ages, slate had been a status symbol for the rich and powerful, it now became affordable for more and more of the population as time went on. Large-scale commercial slate mining in northern Wales began in 1782, with the opening of a quarry in the Ogwen Valley, which later became the famous Penryn Quarry near Bethesda. The rail network, built during the 1800s, had allowed Wales to become the main supplier of slate to England, with the most important slate-producing areas being located in northern Wales. By the year 1882, Wales was responsible for 92% of Britain's slate production, with the quarries of Penryn and the Norwich combined producing about half of the supply. Early workings tended to be in surface pits, which then turned into large open pit quarries. But as the work progressed downwards, it became necessary to start digging underground to continue slate extraction. In some rare instances, such as in Mallfarna, there is no quarry on the surface and slate was obtained entirely underground through mining shafts. Large slabs of slate would be taken out and then transported to the mill, where it would be split and cut into the standard sized roofing slates. In the 19th century, the Spanish created a quarrying process that was efficient enough to produce slate for everyday homes. Its dominance and expertise in this stone still lasts to this day, as nearly 90% of European slate originates from Spain. Galicia, in particular, is the main slate producing region in Spain. Slate roof tiles are usually put in place either with nails or with hooks. In the British Isles, slate is usually fixed with two nails onto timber supports. The nails were traditionally of copper, although nowadays stainless steel is used. In mainland Europe, however, hook fixings are the norm. Both these methods, if used properly, provide a long-lasting roof with a lifespan of around 80 to 100 years. Thanks for watching. If you're interested in learning about more medieval professions, the playlist will be on screen right now. Or if you're interested in history as a whole, you can check out my channel to find a wider variety of historical topics. I'd like to thank my patrons for their support, especially my $25 patrons, Parker Dye and G. David.